Alrighty then, let's get started. The new Pokemon games, Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl came out a couple weeks ago, I think. And I'm having a good time with them. And thought I would just chill out tonight. Not have to worry about Time Spinner, just play these for fun instead. Just gonna relax and do that. Scene seems to be working. That all still works. And as you can see, we're in the middle of a chain right now. Radar going for Marip currently. Chain of 22, so hopefully that doesn't break, but it probably will. Three items, actually. Right. Hello? Oh, that was weird. That was definitely a glitch. It is not me the prompt that it put those items in my bag. I'm gonna save, just in case. I don't really like either of these radar spots. Oh, that one is valid as well. Okay. Go here then. Game audio looks a little loud. Try turning that down a bit. There we go. That's probably better. Of course, I'll probably forget to turn that back up when I go back to other games. Yeah, this is my first time actually doing radar hunting, and it's been an interesting experience. I don't love it, I don't hate it. It's very passive, I will say. Like, kind of just follow the very simple rules. I know that previous radar methods were way more complicated. And you just hope the chain doesn't break. Really just kind of out of your control. So I got here, held item, put it in my bag. There. That's what was not popping up before. Okay. Depending on how long I stream for, I may have to stop and go farm some money to buy more Pokeballs as well. Alright, made it to a chain of 30. Let's see if we keep it. Here. Alright, that's a new record. On the leaderboard. I feel like this chain is going to break any second now, though, so. I don't like that at all. Okay. I didn't really like that one either. I don't know. Maybe I should reset again. I like, that's just me being superstitious, according to the rules that we know so far. There's nothing wrong with either of those patches of grass combinations. Boy, getting close. That's number two on my leaderboard. First. This is where I start getting real nervous. Those are both four away. I'm gonna reset. Box broke at 39. Ugh. Okay. Well, how we doing? Tons of repels left. All right, we got a destiny up. Okay. Well, let's start over. Ooh, two IVs. And yeah, that's kind of what I'm going for, is either a Mareep or a Pachirisu here. Either one I would be happy to get. Pachirisus are a little bit harder to catch, so I've been using quick balls for them. I guess I could have started by knocking out, but it doesn't make a huge difference. Where's the fourth spot? That's weird. Oh, that is all free. Okay, I see. Hey, T-Base. How's it going? Ooh, that one was right in front of me. Okay. We are just trying out the radar shiny hunting method. Here. Trying to get an electric squirrel or an electric sheep, hopefully. Couldn't get to an arc in time. Yeah. That sucks. I mean, there'll be more of them eventually. But yeah, those nearby Pokemon things are sometimes a real trap. Ooh, lots of good stuff in these ones. Heal, max revive, and max potion. Yeah, I didn't even know they were added to Go. I've played very little Pokemon Go recently. Also, how's it going, Silvertown? Okay, sure. Yeah, they've been in for 2 years. That makes sense. Critical capture? Yeah, cool. I wonder if that's based on your dex, like it was in Sword and Shield. Yep. Sounds nice to have some free time. You've got 4 month old. Yep, lots of people getting ready for Endwalker. Surprisingly, didn't hear anything about it at work. I guess no news is good news for that case, I guess. Yeah, I don't know what to say, T-Base. You were on the fence. I think you might remain on the fence. This game... when they announced it, they said faithful remakes, and they are not kidding. There are a lot of very frustrating things that are not in this game. Of quality of life changes that have been in other games, including Platinum. Even, it has just been real weird to see what things they actually brought into this game. Yeah, the underground seems... Actually, I'm pretty happy with the underground implementation. The bits that I've done. I've heard of other people getting, like, absolutely lost, having a ton of fun down there. I think it's fine, but... It seems kind of grindy to get any of the, like, good items from the traders and stuff. But I think it was true of that in the originals as well, so... The online implementation seems to be handled surprisingly well for a Pokemon game. I have not done anything else online with this game, though. I have not done any trades or battles yet, so I actually don't know how that works. But, like, the strangest thing for me is the shiny odds in this game. They are 1 in 4,000. The shiny charm does not work for anything except Masuda breeding. Or breeding in general, I guess. And there's like the Diglett bonus and the underground, which gives a very small boost to it. Yeah, that's still the same. That did not change. You need to talk to 32 NPCs in the underground who are randomly placed. I think random. I think they have set locations, but they're not always there. And then go to one specific spot to get Spiritomb. Thought I had an item. I already have Spiritombs from other games. I even have a shiny Spiritomb, so I'm not concerned about that at all in this game. Like, if the shiny charm doesn't work, there's no reason for me to really work on my decks in this game, so I will complete the decks when home integration is launched. I don't remember, but there is no cap to the flag anymore. The secret bases are just to show off your statues now, which is like, that's also a weird change they made. Yeah. Yeah, there's no traps, there's no flags or anything. Everyone's secret base is just a room full of Pokemon statues. Yes, statues do influence what spawns in the underground. Alright, we're up to a chain of 18, not bad. But yeah, since the Shining Charm doesn't seem to do much, I'm not going to worry about my decks. I'm mainly just going to work on Radar stuff. Like, there's also a lot of post-game stuff I haven't done yet. I'll get to it eventually. I don't feel the rush to need to do everything in this game right away like I did with Sword and Shield. Alright, just like that, we're back up to a chain in the low 20s. And it's gone. Hopefully I don't get trapped in the corner here. Oops. I should have used a Pokeball. Yep, that's what I was afraid of. I surf out of here? I don't think I can. We just started the chain, though, too. But Alright, that was a fun one. Yep, now I get to try and not fall asleep as I count sheep here. Are up to max repels. Nice. So I've already gotten two shinies in this game from Radar already, but both of them were very lucky and very early in the chain. I've got a shiny Bidoof at 6, and then... Why am I blanking on what the other one was? Oh right, a shiny Splink. At chain of 2, and the patch actually was not shiny, so it might have actually been a full odds shiny for that one. Folks sure are picking up a lot of polka dolls. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Unfortunately, I did not. I only got one shiny from each of those chains. In theory, that's the really nice thing about radar hunting, is you can get a shiny and hopefully the chain keeps going and you can get more and more to help get whole evolution lines. Some people in the Discord I'm in getting like 10 shinies off a single chain. Yeah, I'm trying to think here. I have my shiny lily pup was full odds, and then I got a shiny Tentacruel in crystal, or no, gold or silver virtual console. I think those were my only full odds shinies for the 1 in 8,000 odds. Everything else, I think, has been boosted of some variety. Whether it's just they actually lowered the shiny odds in newer games. Yeah, I guess I've never really hunted at full odds before. That just doesn't sound like fun. You happen to get it, that's a cool surprise. The people that specifically only hunt at full odds, don't do anything to improve them intentionally and stuff, are different. Yeah, I don't think I've ever done resets for shinies. Like, that's just not fun to me. And for a while it seemed like the Pokemon Company was trying to discourage as well. Before this, the shiny starters were locked and the box legendaries were locked and stuff. Like, they just felt like they didn't want you to reset. I just want to play the games. I want shinies for some reason. They don't do anything special. I like having them, but I also like playing the games, not just turning it off and on over and over again. In this game, though, which is weird. Like, the starters and the box legendaries aren't locked in this one, I think. I know the starters aren't, because people are doing that. According to Google, Galaga and Palkia are also not shiny locked. Oh, I just put that together, Silvertown. Yeah. Yes, it was impossible for you to get a shiny Yveltal there. That's rough. Also, all the people in this game who was getting shiny Starly in the tutorial combat thing can't catch that one either. Yeah, I'm also, like, not too worried about the legendaries. Like, they're probably going to do events where they do shiny ones and just give them away as well. Like, it might take a while. It might be near the end of the games, like they did in Sword and Shield. Or the next generation to come out. They will probably do a shiny Palkia and shiny Dialga event of some variety. There's tons of shinies, regular and legendaries, you can get from Pokemon Go as well. There's so many options now that I think it's great. Some people are like, oh, shinies from Go aren't worth as much. Like, they're all worthless. They're all just ones and zeros. There's no actual value to any of them. They make me feel good, but there's not actually an economy based around Pokemon. Yeah, Pokemon has been doing stuff like that for ages too. Like, people complained about having to buy the Pokeball Plus to get a Mew and Let's Go Eevee and Pikachu. But, like, they did stuff like that back then. They've done weird distributions. And now in this game, they just give you a Mew for having a save file. Like, what is rare now will be very common later. Max Aethers. Oh, I did not know those were in the item pool. But also, I skipped Gen 3 back in the day, so I missed a lot of the stuff around that. I actually was gonna stream, the Pokemon Emerald Entrance Randomizer. I'd found that a couple weeks ago, and that looked really neat. But I fired it up off stream and took like 3 entrances and was horribly lost. But I realized I have not played a Gen 3 game since Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire. I just had an action replay for Gen 4, so I just actually walked through the walls back then. I don't think I even knew there was a glitch to do it with the bike. But I know that's how I got my first Shaymin Darkrai. That's the other part of these faithful remakes. Apparently in the previous version there was a glitch where you could surf out of bounds in this one and get to Shaymin at least. They just patched that. And some item duplication glitch. Even when they're not trying to be, they are being faithful to remakes. Right, there was a Pokemon duplication glitch in Emerald, wasn't there? That was the reason I bought a copy of Emerald. So I could duplicate Master Balls that they were holding. It was a slow and tedious process, but I used that to bring them into Gen 4 games. I forgot about that. I still had my copy of Emerald. probably traded it into GameStop for like 10 bucks or something back in the day. I don't even want to know what it's going for now. Yep. That sounds about right. Yeah, Pokemon hit kind of a boom. And the pandemic and people collecting stuff. And nostalgia. Just that whole whirlwind of stuff means all the old games have skyrocketed up in price. Yeah, I don't consider myself a collector, but, like, I'm very attached to Pokemon games, so I would like to have at least one game from each generation, but it's been kind of a recent desire, and this is just not the right time to be working on that right now. Like, they will probably come back down at some point. I think this bubble will burst. I could be wrong about that, but. And I have most of my games. I don't know why I got rid of my Gen 3 GBA cartridges, and I still have, like, everything else. That is a Pokemon move. Nice to know that some of the stuff has come down. I don't play at all, but some of the TCG stuff is still ridiculously overpriced as well. And that's kind of what is driving the games as well. It's speculation around the TCG. Dumb YouTubers and stuff. Alright, we're up into the 30s. Don't scare me like that. Dumb repelled pop-up. I ran into something that broke my chain or something. And there we go. Alright. Finally broke. And I don't know why, but I just don't want Weasel right now. really love Weasel, so we're not going to try for that. At least we found Mareep again very quickly. So that's nice. I feel like I haven't gotten anything from the pickups in a while. That just takes time as well. That's not important either. Just some extra items as I'm doing other stuff. Thank you. probably stop pushing my luck and try start catching these, shouldn't I? Just the chair. There we go. Hopefully we get the shiny in this chain, but either way, once this chain breaks, I'm gonna take a short stretch break. So that could be very soon or quite a ways from now. Just a heads up. keep going. Hope it doesn't break, I guess. That was a shiny patch for a second. Okay. Wait, what are these? One away. Oh, both of those are. Okay. There's the chain. That broke. Yeah, I think we'll take a short stretch break here. Get up, refill my beverage and whatnot. Yeah. And then come back and do some more radar stuff. Yeah, stick around. BRB. I do this. Nice little stretch break. My avatar stretches as well. Okay. How are we doing for quotes? My main concern. Yeah, still got 187. Audio's still lagging. Hoping that fix that during the break as well. Don't know how to fix that without breaking everything then. Alright, well, guess we'll just have to deal with it. At 187, I think it can go for a little bit longer. What new engine do I have here? Oh. Hey, Greg! How's it going? Pretty good. Just relaxing and trying to catch a shiny with radar and trying not to get frustrated when my chain breaks randomly. First time playing a game like Raider. Well, I think it was in Auras, but I didn't do it then. And like, I think I'm doing fine at it. It's just get unlucky sometimes with a 7% chance. I'm just glad there's not like multiple kinds of shakes and you need to go to the right one or anything like that. That stuff always looked real difficult, watching other people do it. It's nice that I could just go to the one that is four away. Yeah, like that's frustrating. Like, I didn't know when I first started that you needed to catch instead of knockout. That gives you better chances. Once I learned that, I felt better about it. And then it's just like, based on those odds, you only have a 5% chance to make it actually to a chain of 40. So. Like, your odds with this method still aren't great. It's just gonna take time to get there. So, that's how I'm trying to look at it. You even if you do everything right, you still only have a 5% chance to making it to 40, so. But you could get lucky before that, like, both of my radar shinies have been on a chain of 6 and a chain of 2, so. You can still get lucky along the way as well. I've actually not even made it to 40 yet. Ooh, luxury ball decks. That's cool. Reminds you of Picross. Love Picross. I can see that. I didn't think about that before, but yeah. I can see it totally scratching that itch. Just like looking at the grid, checking where all 4 spots are, trying to figure out which one is the farthest away. Huh. So how's it going, Rogue Kitty? Welcome on in. Yeah, I'm not worried about the decks at all, because apparently the shiny charm only works for breeding, so. I will just get fully to Pokedex once home integration is added. I can just move in my living decks and move it back out. Mainly, I just don't want to worry about catching Pokemon in honey trees. I don't want to set timers and stuff like that, personally, so. Yeah, I haven't done any breeding. I've bred like 1 Pokemon in this game so far, but I remember doing a lot of breeding back in the original Diamond and Pearl. Got all the starters and luxury balls? Nice! At first I was like, wait, how did you do that? Oh right, underground. There's a lot of cool stuff in the underground. I should do more underground stuff. I need to get some of those gems for the Ramanas Park, see what that's all about. I still don't even know how that works. Oh, that sounds like fun. Victory Ball playthrough of Pearl. Nice. I'm still on the fence if I will even get a copy of Pearl or not. Like, I am enjoying this game, but I don't know if this is worth me picking up a second copy. I think this might be the first one in a long time where I just have one. Well, no, I only had one copy of Let's Go Eevee as well. Yeah, I only had Let's Go in one version. Yeah, I was on the fence about doing that Amazon pre-order, but I kind of assumed there would be some other way to get the Apricorn Balls in this game. And guess I was wrong. I'm sure once they open up, like, the GTS or whatever, there will be plenty of people sending out rejects of stuff in Apricorn Balls, so. That's just so weird, like. I just don't get it. Offering something that's just not available in the game at all, like. They can do whatever they want. Like, it was a smart move on their play. Props to them. Yeah, they made a lot of interesting choices. At the end of the day, it's still a Pokemon game. I'm still having a good time with it. I dislike some of the choices, but I don't actually hate this game. That chain. Yeah, like, me too. Like, there are just so many quality of life changes they chose not to bring over. Whether it was an active choice or just a choice of admission, they decided not to do a lot of things that left me scratching my head. Whoever decided to autosave automatically when your chain breaks, I don't like you, but you made the right choice. Yes, two buttons on the watch, just... I think that means I just always leave my watch on the radar app and just don't use it for anything else. My Poketch is a radar screen and that's all it is. Two IVs. Chair. It's slow going, but I do like how chill the radar is. Just relax. I don't have to think too hard. Yeah, SOS was great too. Like, once you set up the harvest method, man, it took me way too long to set that up. I was doing some manually before. Yeah, once you got that set up, it's pretty passive as well. Just make sure you don't accidentally knock out the shiny. Tried not to SOS hunt late at night in bed, because I was definitely noticed that I was not paying full attention to the new Pokemon that were coming in. I was definitely scared I was going to knock out a shiny as I was falling asleep. Glad you got it. I meant to go on the one beneath this, but shouldn't matter. They're both far away. can break the chain, so I'm happy, I guess. I should double check that those were actually four away. Alright, I should be using Pokeballs, the Mareeps. Be saving my Quick Balls for Pachirisus. Oops. Starting to feel like my two radar shinies were just really, really lucky. All right, good IVs. Not that it really matters. I'm not going to be doing competitive. And there are bottle caps supposedly in this game, so. I knew how to fix this audio delay. But yeah, if I try and mess with it, I'll just make things worse while I'm streaming. But I'm just not gonna touch it and just deal with it. OBS on Linux is very finicky, especially about changing audio devices. Hey, we haven't picked anything up in a while. There it is. And there goes that chain. I didn't even know what we were at. I was just mindlessly doing it. Nope. Don't want a Buizel right now. Part of the process. I'll do Shellos later. We'll eventually radar for these. Right now, I really want an electric sheep or an electric squirrel. Go. Start the chain again. Thank you. think if I don't get it in this chain, I'll probably do like one more long chain after that. We still don't get any shinies by then. I think I'll call it there for the night. I don't know how long that's going to take, but I just wanted to announce it now. At some point I have to mass release all of these electric animals that I have caught. Then I'll probably do some underground stuff, but the audio lag is also starting to get to me, and I think it would be really annoying doing the tapping stuff underground and having the sound come out like a second later, so yes, we've caught a lot of sheep. That's another thing, is like, so the shiny hunting method in this game has you catching a lot of Pokemon, but there isn't a like mass release function in this game. Like, it's fast. Like, the button inputs to release Pokemon are not bad. They're pretty, you can do them pretty quickly, but they had to have known that people are going to catch a ton of the same Pokemon and just want to get rid of all of them at once. Yeah, just let me select an entire box and just release them all at once. Should do that. I thought I was real smart and was just resetting, but I realized it auto-saves when your chain breaks, and I'm not going to turn off auto-save in a game that is this buggy as well. Like, I haven't had it crash, I haven't heard of it crashing for anyone else, but I'm still not competent enough to turn off autosave in this game. Like, at the start of stream, I had some weirdness with taking the items off my Pachirisus would pick up, where it was, like, not, like, really displaying the you got this item and stuff, which was kind of weird, but the only, like, glitch I've had so far, except for, like, the obvious, like, weird movement stuff as well. This game was just not meant to be controlled with both a D-pad and a control stick. Oh, one of them had a bottle cap? That's nice. I still need to get more levels on my Pachirisus, get better items still. Like, what, level 39, I think? But I'm still getting in good stuff. Not complaining about max ethers and max potions and stuff. Okay. Thought it was a Roomba. What is the table here? Okay. Ooh, once I get to the next category, I will stop getting Poke Dolls. Alright. I've not gotten a Dusk Stone yet. I've got the other two. Nuggets. Ooh, I could get a Leftovers? That would be nice. And then, yeah, you start getting Bottle Caps at level 70. Okay. Yeah, I've gotten a lot of Shiny Stones, a lot of Dawn Stones, and I've not gotten a single Dusk Stone yet from mine. Thank you. Made it to 18. Getting there. Almost halfway. Not want to go in that top left one. Critical capture. Missed the audio cue for that.
Bye.
Alright, we're above 25. Now I start getting nervous every time. What do we have for odds right now? Just stop gaining. 1 in 1600? Okay. So we're not even at shiny charm odds in other games. Need to be above 30 for that. Okay. Oh, that's awful. What is that? All in a row? Sure, whatever. Alright, yeah, that weird formation didn't break my chain, so all of my dumb superstitions are probably not true. Any spot that's four away has the same odds. Just go for it. Don't think about it. Just do it. Random 2IV, I guess? We're not at 30 yet, are we? I lost count. Like, definitely not paying attention to the numbers, but maybe we are at 30. Okay, that was 30. All right. There it is. The chain of 32. We got it. All right. Cute pink little fluff ball. Awesome. All right. Thank you. All right. Feels good. Finally get third shiny from Radar. Can probably just try. Didn't even need to bring in Paris. Yeah, didn't even need to swap. Alright, we got one. Does it continue? It does. Alright, can we get more for the family? This corner is fine. You can get out. This corner. It's just the top left corner is where I could become trapped. I guess now I don't have to be as worried about the chain breaking. Like, it would be nice to get two more so I could have the whole line, but I also can rebuild this. Thank you. Ah, there we go. And there's the chain all over. Alright, what's this mess look like? Oh. Yeah, we're gonna deal with that off stream. This is the one we want. Alright. Not great nature, not great IVs or anything, but got a shiny on stream. I'm happy. These are the two I've gotten off stream, so that's great. Awesome. I think I said I was going to do another chain, but I think that's enough for tonight. Thank you, Rogue Kitty. I've got to clean out my boxes, and then I'll probably do some underground stuff off stream tonight. Yeah, that was fun. All it there. Thank you, everyone who stopped on by. Good time. Just hanging out. Feels good to stream stuff other than Time Spinner every once in a while. Other games do exist. Let's see if there's anybody we can raid. Yeah, it looks like buddy Wef Jepster's doing some free enterprise randomizer. Pay him a visit. That tab was definitely supposed to be muted. And yeah, I'll be streaming again on Sunday. No idea what it'll be. It'll be something. Probably randomizer of some variety. And yeah. Until then, I hope you all have a wonderful night. Stay safe, have fun, and you got this. Peace.